Welcome to Ketchikan Public Library's DIY with Gail. I'm Gail. Good morning. It's a wet day in Ketchikan, so I picked a craft that would be quick and easy and I hope fun. I picked this little bag because I wanted to give away some things, and a brown paper bag just doesn't cut it. And I thought, why not? I will tell you, I left my cording a little long. You can do what you please with it. But look, the contrasting colors. If you did this in green and red, I think it even looked like a little strawberry. I'll show you what I have inside and why I was motivated to do this. I have family members who've been coming and helping. And so we made cookies. Actually, hubby made the cookies. I'm making the bag. So this is why I'm doing it. And this is what it's going to look like. I have a smaller version here so you can take a nice peek. I've laid it out. It takes two pieces of fabric. I'm going to use 17 by 17. My cord measures between 23 and 46 inches because I simply can't make up my mind how I want my cording or how I'm going to tie it. So I'm going to leave that up to you to figure out on your own because I can't figure it out on mine yet. All right, to begin with, as I said, two pieces of material, contrasting colors. Mine, I have chosen to cut 17 by 17. That's what my cookie bag size was. You can do this in any size square, as long as you remember to make it a square. Right sides together. We're going to sew around the edges. We're going to leave a spot in the bottom so that we can turn it, okay? And through magic, of course, I have one already sewn and I left the hole in the bottom. Now on this project, we're gonna clip our corners because we want these peaks or these points really pointed. We want them to come out looking awesome on our bag, okay? So I'm gonna turn this right side out. I just did a simple quarter inch seam around there. And once it's right side out, now in other videos I told you that probably the most important tool in sewing is the iron. And in this project, you will definitely need your iron because you want to make sure that these seams are nice and flat because we're gonna do a top stitch on this. Around it. I did not do the top stitch on the first bag that I did, and I regret it because I think it would have made the little points look much nicer. All right, so once you get this all right way, and then you want to flatten, 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 go into your corners with your scissors closed or use a pencil or something else if you worry that you might snip. You want to go into that corner and push gently, very gently, because we want our corners to be nice and pointed. Again, right to the point, gently. I mean, you can feel it. You don't want to push hard because you don't want to push those scissors through there or something like that. Okay, get all four of those corners. Somehow or another, I got my scissor caught in there. All right, pull it out. And you can wiggle your fingers too, and that will also bring it. It will not put a perfect point, but it does work. Just roll your fingers, and it will come right out. The other thing is, like I said, we want this to lay very flat. So use finger pressing to get it out there. If it's not, use the moisture on your fingers to go like that and it will come. Okay, so I'm gonna go around making sure my edges look pretty good, that they're not poked in like this. See how it goes in there? If I iron that, that's gonna end up making this little lip there. We do not want that. We want that seam right out there. Okay, now I'm gonna go over here to my ironing board. like I said, the iron is extremely important if you're going to do top stitching, because you want it to lay out really nice. I didn't do that one with my fingers. Now my piece was already ironed. I ironed it before I cut it. Right here is where my hole was that I turned, and you'll can see my seam is down. I've ironed it flat. I did not get this point, so let me pull that point out because I want this bag perfect. Well, as perfect as Gail gets. Okay. All right, once you get that all ironed up, look at how nice and flat that is. And that's going to be much nicer going through my presser foot and stuff, you know, through my feed dog. And it'll be much easier. I don't have to pin. I don't have to do anything. Okay? So all I'm going to do, and I'm using white thread. Do color, you know, coordinate your stuff. I'm using white thread so you can see it. I want you to be able to see it. And all I'm doing is putting my presser foot along the edge and just doing a nice little top stitch all the way around. Make sure that point comes out right. So do your measurements. Okay, I'm going to turn and see. One more. It looks like I can do one more stitch to make it perfect. There we go. Check those turns because you want it to look right, especially if you're using a color that's going to stand out. And my white definitely stands out on this green. If I make a mistake, you're going to see it. Any wobble. So I invited you to my coffee table today to sew because this is my favorite, absolute favorite area to sew. I sit here most evenings with the TV on and I just sew away. I love it. Sewing is probably the most, oops, I ran out of thread. Look at that, my bobbin is dead. And I try to remember to do that for you guys, to get everything set up before, but it doesn't always happen that way. So we're gonna wind the bobbin. The bobbin is a simple thing to wind. I happen to have a Brother sewing machine. Over the years, actually all the years, I have chosen a Brother machine just because I love them. They're simple, very simple. I don't have any fancy gadgets on it, although I was watching YouTube the other day and turns out, wow, you can get some fancy gadgets nowadays. As I said, mine is very simple. Quick, easy bobbin fill. I try not to bite the string anymore. They tell me it's bad for your teeth. You grind them down. All right, and now the machine. If you don't know how to thread your machine, there are many YouTube videos. All you have to do is look up the type of machine you have. There are some fantastic videos out there. I highly recommend spending some time looking at the YouTube videos. I spend a lot of time watching YouTube videos, especially on sewing. All right, we're back in. So if that happens to you, just go back a little bit, line your needle up into the thread line that you've already gotten there. Okay, so I am actually back a bit on my thread, so now that when I start going, it's just gonna be like I backed up and did a double there. I'll come back and flip the thread and whatnot. Now these corners are important. You really, really want to pay attention to your stitching. because when we get to the part where we're going to fold over these corners where our cording's going to go in, oh yeah, it counts. It took me a little bit of time to get it figured out on the big ones there. You'll have to do a little bit of math if you, you know, do make one of these. Or guess by eye. If it's a little off, who's gonna know? Alright, I've made my stitches all the way around. Put that out of the way for the moment. Pretty good, not too bad. It looks pretty straight. Like I said, you go ahead and use colors that will disappear, but I wanted you to be able to see. Alright, now you have to decide which is the inside of your bag and which is the outside of the bag. I personally want the inside of the bag to be the green, so flip it over, and then we're just going to make these, the corners, fold down. And as I said, here's where the math comes in. Oh, let me trim this up a little bit. Try and get your strings when you see them, otherwise you won't remember where they are, and sometimes they disappear, and then you give them out, and the next thing you know, huh, your strings are everywhere. And you've already given it to somebody. All right, I did bring my little measurer here. And what we're looking for is we're gonna look for the measurement between our triangles, or whatever they are. All right, and I'm going to cheat because I don't remember what it was on this one. So we're just gonna, because it's the same size, 5 inches. Okay, 5 inches it is. Look at that. All right, so the next thing I want to do is just make sure that they're all 5. This one is not, but it's close. Take a pin and keep that point in place. Just worry about the point. Don't worry about anything else, okay? And then we said 5 inches. About there. I will say it again, unless you forget, in case you've forgotten, I am not any type of perfectionist or I am not a, what do you call it, a professional, that's the word I was looking for, by any means. I do this for fun and only fun. So you're welcome to join me for fun anytime. All right, so my points are in, okay? So those are those cute little, in this case, I'm thinking of them as leaves, okay? And I am going to use my sewing machine edge, the silver edge here, for how wide I want my area for the cording. That's this area that we're doing right now. We're gonna stitch this so that our cording can be threaded through there. I'm going to start where it can't be seen as well, right about here. Like I said, I'm using the silver for my measurement, okay? And this is where it gets kind of crazy. I told you about turning the points so you got them just right, you know, the right amount. And we're going to make a corner here where this one starts. Have to play. Look at that. So when I made my corner right here, I measured and it lines up right here. That's what I want. Now we're going to go across here, and I highly recommend putting your fingers here, unless you have one of those that come down and beat your fingers up. Put your fingers there to help hold it down when the presser foot comes to it. There we go. Once you get across that lip, it seems to be all right. But on the first one that I did, oh my goodness, it flipped over several times. again, we're keeping an eye out. This is going to be a corner here. Let's see. Not far enough yet. Maybe three more. Too many. So what do? We just back up. And there it is. You want those corners nice. And nobody's going to see that unless they look on the inside of the bag, and I'll show you that after. Again, that corner. Make sure that your needle is down when you go to turn so that you don't pull. I don't know if I mentioned that already or not. It's very important to have the needle down when you make your turn. There we go. And you'll see by putting my pins up here in the point, I don't have to worry about pulling them as I'm sewing. Okay, let's see. Perfect. Too far. Everything flat, especially if you don't use pins. If you don't use pins, you want to make sure that you're holding it and keeping it in place. All right. Remembering to hold that down, like I said, otherwise that will try and fold up. And that one is trying. So I'm going to put my needle down, lift my presser foot, flatten it out under there, and then continue on. And we're coming into where we started. Go over it so that it's overlapped. Clip your strings. Okay. All right, so that spot that I went too far and had to back up, right there. And that's all you're going to see of that mess up, okay? It doesn't show on the front. Stay right there. I'm going to turn it. You can't see it on the front. You can only see it on the inside, okay? All right, so now we're going to pull our pins. Pull four pins. And our cord. Now, what do I do with my pin? I have a safety pin around here somewhere. Safety pins for doing cording, elastic, all of that stuff that has to go through the little bands or whatever, put a safety pin on it. A safety pin will get you anywhere. This one can be a big one because I have a big hole. And then just thread. And you can just pull the pin as you go. See that? To the next one. I will tell you, I did not measure this cord or anything. I'm just, because I want to choose a purple actually, but I want to finish this up so you can see it completed. Now remember, you can add beads to the end of your cord. You could add little buttons and stuff on your little flaps here. Tons of little things you can add to it. All right, so now we go like that. Pull tight. Oops. Pull tight. Okay, without anything in it, of course it's not going to stand up, but you get the idea. And look at our little ends. I just think they're so adorable. I really like the top stitching. I didn't do top stitching on this one, and I wish I had, because I think it just gives it a finished look. So that's how you make the bag. As I said, you can use it for whatever you want. If you keep the long strings, you got a cute little purse. So you can do whatever you please with it. Just have a fun time. Also, you do not have to use a sewing machine. All of this can be done by hand. Remember, stay safe, mask on, and we are open at the Ketchikan Public Library. We are still in phase two. Phase three is coming. I heard it's coming. We'll see you soon. Take care.